When you feel it's hopeless, when you think that you've lost all, I will take your hand and we'll rise up from the dust.
Hello, I'm Dr. Richard Okoye, the president of Doctors Save a Life Foundation. I'm putting on black today just to notify everyone in this country that we're not having a happy hour when it has to do with the healthcare delivery, the health of our people because of COVID-19. People are burying their loved ones. Prominent men and women in this country who are touching the life of their family, their community, the country in general, they have been today being buried in a very humiliating manner as a result of COVID-19. Even their families that will be in a state of mourning could be subjected to all manner of humiliation, harassment, and stigmatization on the basis of COVID-19. I want to put it across to everyone today that most of the deaths you are hearing in this country today are not COVID-19 related. Ask me why I should come up with this and why I have this very important to share this thing to everyone. Let me at this juncture put this thing very bare. As most of our professionals also know, the most critical and the life-threatening symptoms of COVID is respiratory distress. When it has to do, the person cannot breathe. And most of them will be gasping for air until they go. But there's something I want to bring up to our attention. Before the onset of COVID-19, people have been having breathlessness. Breathlessness secondary to congestive heart failure. From asthmatic attack, people have been having the issue that has to do with renal failure, from which they will at a point become so tired, not being able to breathe. A number of chronic illnesses can prune people from breathlessness. But today, we have been able to summarize people having such a situation, all COVID-19. I want to use this opportunity to call upon the Honorable Minister of Health, ACDC, the governors. Please, it is time for us to look into a very critical subject, a very critical issue I want to share with us now with respect to the health of our people. Can we sit down with our 5 months of experience and be able to form our protocol? Most of our patients, most of our people can no more come to hospital. Most hospitals cannot admit them. Even those that have a problem that the hospital already know. I should tell you this, ever since St. Nicholas Hospital, as big as those hospitals, even having their isolation ward was shut down on the basis of COVID, most private hospitals can't admit patients. Then we say, go and get paper from ACDC before you will be treated. And a person that may have congestive heart failure, that may have something that has to do with renal impairment, that may have asthmatic attack, will all be gone and be buried all in the name of COVID-19. I have a pain in my heart while I'm talking this. This very morning, we lost a prominent Nigerian who has touched his family, community, and in a state man as it were. And this is a man with a known hypertensive heart failure being managed. The experience came and all the hospitals they were rejected to the point of taking the man back to the house, and the man died in the house. Today it will be called COVID-19. The families will all be quarantined. It is time we change this narrative. It is time we look at how these things could be reviewed. After a while, there should be a room for review. There happened to be a woman, a prominent woman in Owerri, who had been known to be an asthmatic patient. This woman went to several hospitals. Nobody can take. Are we going to blame private hospital this time? If anybody admits, if anybody tries to assist, and a story of COVID is attached, number one is that the hospital may be shut down. And secondly, stigmatization of the hospital also, that it has become a COVID hospital. How long can we remain in this? It is time for us to change this narrative, because no matter how we feel, if it don't touch you, if it don't touch you, it may touch your loved one, it may touch somebody very, very close to you. Listen to me, as I'm talking to you right now, there are a lot of sick Nigerians right there in their homes. All afraid of coming out, have been identified, have been a COVID-19 patient. Most of them will be using some health workers just to be going to the house because of the fear of stigmatization and so many things. Can we let these people out? Can we let them understand by reason of the statistics we have today in our country? Not a thing to celebrate that we have lost a patient to COVID. However, from the statistics we've maintained in the past 5 months, it has been established that in the past 5 months, that our statistics have shown that we have about 3% mortality. As it stands today, it's 2.6 mortality. A recovery of 34% following COVID. Now, my question, Nigeria has a life expectancy of 55 years. Could COVID-19 of this 2.6% mortality in a nation like this be responsible for our 55 years life expectancy rate? Of course not. It is time we be able to come back. Please, I'm just pleading. I'm just making an appeal to the Honorable Minister of Health, to NCDC, to our governors, even the legislators. Please, can we come to this reality? Is there a way we could be able to change this very protocol? Is there a way we should be able to put certain things right? And I'm here to make certain recommendation, rather more accurately, a suggestion where it could be applied. Please let us be in position to help our loved ones already in the Delta. They are, I'm telling you, most of them that are hypertensive, they have been managing themselves, but today they cannot come out because the heart is not pumping blood as it's supposed to pump. What will happen? Edema will come. The person will be having breathlessness. He can't breathe. He has to go to hospital and he can be assisted. But they don't have a chance. They don't have a chance. The hospitals are afraid of receiving them. They have to wait even to get the diagnosis perhaps from NCDC before they will be able to give an attention to patients that have been living with us even before the arrival of the COVID-19. Let me make this very emphatic statement. We are not here to debate whether COVID-19 is real or not, or the issue whether it is done a business or not by reason of anything. I want to make it very clear that COVID-19 is real. We confirm cases of death following COVID-19. But we are looking at how do we be in position to be able to manage other cases that have been there and killing our people, bringing Nigerian life expectancy to as low as 55 years. Those things are still there. As a matter of fact, contributing to more mortality than even what we have been able to obtain so far from COVID-19. These are my suggestions. Number one, and the most important of them all, is the understanding that the healthcare system in Nigeria currently is private hospital dependent. It's the private hospitals that actually make the bedrock of most of our healthcare delivery in this country. And on that very ground, I'm suggesting good job done by NCDC by containing this very virus to this very point of 2.6% mortality. Well done. I must acknowledge and appreciate you for that job. Well done. But at this particular point in time, we need to go a little further. How do we be in position to save our kidney patient, asthmatic patient, patient of different chronicities that are free to come out today because people will assume they have COVID? I'm suggesting possibly let the ACDC, the Ministry of Health, The governors have a meeting with the leadership of AGPNP, the arm of the private doctors organization. Let their leadership sit down. How best could we be in position to work in collaboration with NCDC? Whereby every hospital can be instructed. If you have a case of an index of suspicion, you can have an isolation ward. SCDC could also get involved. Go around the different hospitals, check out a place you can recommend for an isolation, and let them work in partnership. With that isolation ward available in the hospitals, one, it will save the life of most of the people that are having already a chronic illness and needing some level of emergency attention. In addition to that, NCDC could be said to be a better doctor when it has to do with the issue of managing COVID-19 patients. NCDC has gotten sufficient knowledge, acquired sufficient experience, which I feel at this very point in time is a very big treasure to our country, to the health of our people, to the healthcare system. And that very knowledge, it is time for us to decentralize it. Let's reach out to the private hospitals, to the tertiary hospital, to train the doctors. This is the protocol you people have used to be able to survey the lives of over 3,000 patients. It's a kudos to you, what every Nigerian should be able to appreciate. But at this very point in time, we need to transmit that very information. Not training them on the fear factor of COVID-19, but to train them on what you have done to get 34% success. Huge. A number of them still in the United States. 34% should be emphasized, should be celebrated. Over 2.6% mortality, which when everybody got to know what you know, to a very large extent, we can still find that 2.6% mortality down to 1% in a couple of months to come. We have to beckon on the support of the government. Even in these pockets of isolation, war that the hospitals can be developed within the hospitals, the government can support either as a grant to the hospitals or even with the supply of equipment, even its PPEs. I want to appreciate the government of Cross River State for building up a factory that today we can have enough PPE for our doctors, for our health workers across the country. The government can partner with private hospitals to be in position to support, even with the PPE, where ventilation is required, the government can support the centers with ventilators. Finally, I want to beckon on our people. This is a very dangerous time for the health of our people. If you are diabetic, hypertensive, or having a heart-related problem, or having any form of renal-related impairment, I encourage you, step out where you are. Do not go on self-medication. Make sure you visit the hospital as often as possible. Let them identify the problem you have. On the day of complication, they will know that has been the case they have been managing all this while. They can give you a help in a time like this. Thank you for listening. I remain your friend, Dr. Richard Okoye, the president of Doctors Save a Life Foundation. We share a vision that by the year 2025, Nigerian life expectancy currently seated at 55 years, suffering again in the hand of COVID-19, we hit 70 years come 2025. I want you to be part of this. Together, we can build a healthy family, a healthy nation, and a healthy continent, Africa. I want us to share this message. I want us to push this thing across to everyone. God bless you as you do that.